Welcome to another meta snapshot breakdown. The Wailing Caverns meta has fully settled, and players are trying to find a way to gain an edge on ladder. While some players are experimenting, the majority have found their groove and continue to abuse Tier 1 decks until the newest expansion releases on August 3rd. Luckily for us, Blizzard has assured us that a balance patch will be pushed live next Thursday, saving us from our Priest Overlords. While the cards that will be nerfed aren't confirmed, Blizzard did say that the cards will be targeting Priest Generation, Burst Healing, and even Druid's ability to force non-games. We here at Tempo Storm are predicting that we'll see Apotheosis, Raise Dead, and Gibberling nerfed, but only time will tell which cards will be hit. What cards do you expect to see nerfed? Let us know in the comments below. Before we jump into the top decks in the meta, be sure to visit our website over at tempostorm.com to view the rest of the report. Without further ado, let's take a look at what decks are leading the meta. As we implied, Control Priest is leading the fray once again in this meta snapshot breakdown. This class can be pretty tilting to play against at times, and if you've been on social media, you've surely seen people complaining about it. While Priest is the best deck in the game, it also has the ability to drain fun from your opponent, making it even more grueling to play against. Thankfully, it'll be toned down soon, but for many players, next week can't come fast enough. For those who love Priest or want a control deck to climb with, our featured Control Priest will give you the results you desire if you put the time in to learn it. Control Priest performs best against aggressive decks that aim to fight for board, or aggro decks that use a set amount of burn to close out the game. These decks struggle in the face of Priest due to Anduin's continued healing and removal. As for bad matchups, Control Priest continues to struggle against aggro Shaman. While you might think the healing is enough to get Priest through this matchup, the Shaman can often push enough chip damage to close the game out using either Doomhammer or Instructor Fireheart. Next up in Tier 1 is the previously mentioned aggro Shaman. This archetype rose to fame following the release of Wailing Caverns, and it has been performing exceptionally well thanks to the new cards it received that give the deck more consistency. On top of this, the already powerful class is not facing any balance changes on Thursday, leaving it in a prime spot to dominate the meta. It may lose one of its better matchups if Priest gets significantly toned down, but this will depend on how hard the nerfs hit. Aggro Shaman aims to take the board early with cheap elementals, then tries to close it out using Doomhammer, Rockbiter, and Stormstrike. Thrall's premier deck performs best when facing off against Control Priest and Miracle Rogue, as Aggro Shaman can just abuse them with its minions before closing the game out with unavoidable burst damage. As for bad matchups, Aggro Shaman tends to have a difficult time against OTK Demon Hunter, as they can just stave off your pressure with massive heals before closing out the game using their combo. They also are known to run Acidic Swamp Ooze at times, making it even worse. The last deck we'll be taking a look at in Tier 1 today is Token Druid. This is the only other deck being nerfed in the coming patch due to its ability to make games end before they even begin. With a good player and a good hand, Druids can lock their opponent out by developing large and durable Gibberling boards, making it slightly miserable to play against. Luckily, this will be addressed soon, but for the time being, this archetype is the best board-centric deck that isn't Shaman. The new Fire Festival Malfurion skin just came out, making this the best deck to try it out with. Token Druid wants to queue into decks that can't do much against the wide boards, or give it time to assemble its pieces to the puzzle. Decks such as Deathrattle Demon Hunter or Miracle Rogue tend to scoop to Druid's onslaught, making these prime matchups. On the flip side, Druid really hates queuing into decks that can easily remove the board time and time again, such as Control Priest or OTK Demon Hunter. Your boards are seldom safe against these decks, so beware. Tier 2 continues to boast several more decks than its Tier 1 counterpart, so as usual, we'll dive into the top 3 in the tier. We want to take a quick second to remind you to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Hearthstone content if you're enjoying the tier list so far. Now let's jump into Tier 2. Leading off Tier 2 is Rush Warrior. This archetype fell from the first tier, with Token Druid rising up to its spot. Rush Warrior remains a competitive deck, but still struggles in the face of Priest. The more Priests on ladder, the worse of a time that Warrior will find itself having. Rush Warrior continues to feature the same game plan by developing minions on curve and holding a grip on the board with its rush minions. Rush Warrior performs best against decks that struggle to retake the board once lost, such as Deathrattle Demon Hunter or Miracle Rogue. As we said before, Rush Warrior has a hard time against Priest due to Anduin's ability to remove literally all of your threats, denying you the ability to close out the game. The next deck making an appearance in Tier 2 is Elemental Shaman. This deck is very similar to Aggro Shaman, but it moves away from the Doomhammer package into more elementals. This deck plays similarly, but it's more board-centric, making it more durable against cards such as Acidic Swamp Ooze. While this version of Shaman has a worse matchup spread compared to Aggro Shaman, it is favored in the mirror, making it a good choice to play if you're queuing into a lot of other Shamans. Aside from the Shaman mirror, this deck performs best against Control Priest due to how durable your early game threats are. Unlike Aggro Shaman, Elemental Shaman does have a bad matchup against Miracle Rogue, as without the over-the-top burn, you can find yourself struggling to close out the game. The last deck we'll be taking a look at today is Aggro Hunter. This aggressive form form of Hunter has been making a name for itself with how prevalent it has been on ladder. Its ability to make an explosive start straight out of the gate has gained it notoriety, and this deck will continue to dominate board as long as it's alive in Standard. Aggro Hunter is the last of the excessive amount of aggressive decks we're discussing in this breakdown, and it's one of the more traditional face decks, aiming to take board and close out the game with burn spells. Aggro Hunter takes advantage of some of the slower aggro decks on ladder, such as Elemental or Aggro Shaman. That's not to say that those decks are slow, but they're certainly slower than Hunter, and they will struggle to mount a comeback once behind. Much like other aggro decks, Aggro Hunter has a very rough time against Control Priest, with this matchup feeling unwinnable at times unless you draw a perfect hand. The Hearthstone meta is in a weird place. The game is relatively balanced, but a few outliers are warping the meta to a point where it isn't exactly fun to queue up games. Hopefully the upcoming balance patch resets things, but only time will tell if we'll be waiting for the new expansion to save us. Thank you for watching yet another Tempo Storm Meta Snapshot Breakdown. We hope this meta report helped you prepare yourself for ladder so that you can achieve the best rank possible. If this video helped you, please be sure to subscribe to our channel to be kept up to date with all of our Hearthstone content. We'll see you next time.